Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. Now we are going to talk about what are the factors that are affecting the ionization enthalpy. Because in the earlier lecture we have studied about the ionization enthalpy SS, we have also discussed about how the second ionization enthalpy is greater than the first ionization enthalpy, and we have discussed about the few reasons also because of which it was the second ionization enthalpy was greater than the first ionization enthalpy. So related to that, we are going to talk about that what are the other factors also that would affect the ionization enthalpy of a particular atom or ion. Let us talk about that. So these are the factors that will affect the ionization enthalpy. So those are size of atoms, nuclear charge, Schilling effect and nature of the electronic configuration. So let us talk about each of them one by one, and let us discuss that how does it affects the ionization enthalpy. So talking about the first one, that is the size of atom. The size of atom plays a very vital role for an ionization enthalpy. How? Because if the atomic size is more, or if ionic size is more, if we talk in that term, then what happens is the nucleus and the distance between the nucleus and the outermost electron, or the we could say that the outermost valence shell, that would be very much more in case of when the atomic size is more. So if the atomic size is more, then we could say that the nuclear charge will be less, or we could say that the attraction between the nucleus and the outermost electron will be less. So this plays a very easy role, or this requires in this case a very less energy so as to remove the electrons, because the size is more, because of which the nuclear charge or the attraction of the nucleus to the outermost electron will be less, and hence now electrons can be removed easily. So now when it comes to the size of the atom, it can be easily said that the ionization enthalpy depends inversely on the atomic size. That means if the atomic size is more, then the ionization enthalpy would be very much less. So this is how the size of the atom plays a very important role for an ionization enthalpy. So similarly, when we are talking about periods and groups, so for that, if we move from left to right across the period, what happens is because of the atomic size goes on reducing, and because of which the nuclear charge increases, and if the nuclear charge increases, then it is but obvious that the electron that is being very much attracted to the central nucleus will be more, and because of which the energy required to remove that electron which is now being more attracted towards the nucleus, or which had an influence with the nucleus, will be more, and hence the energy required will be more to remove that electron. But when we come talk about the groups, that is when the atomic size goes on increasing, when we come to down the group, and since the atomic size goes on increasing, what happens is the nuclear charge goes on decreasing, or we could say that the nuclear attraction with the outermost electron will go on decreasing, and hence it would be very much easy for us to remove that electron, and hence that is what we have made a statement that the atomic size is inversely proportional to the ionization enthalpy. So this was the first factor, and now let us talk about the second one. Second one is the one that we have discussed recently, that is when we are talking about nuclear charge. So this is the main reason that depends on ionization enthalpy. How? Because nuclear charge is nothing but the force of attraction between the nucleus and the outermost electron, so as to hold the electron in the atom itself. So if the nuclear charge is more, then we could say that the ionization enthalpy will be more, means we will require more energy so as to remove that electron which is under the influence of the nuclear charge, and hence the electron will require more energy, and we will need more energy so as to remove that electron. We should provide more energy. So that's the reason it can be easily said that the nuclear charge is basically directly proportional to ionization enthalpy, which means ionization enthalpy will be more if the nuclear charge is more for a particular atom or for a particular ion, if you would say in that manner also. So this is what the ionization enthalpy is. has a dependence on the nuclear charge directly. So now talking about the next one, that is screening effect. Screening effect, also known as shielding effect, it plays a very vital role in the ionization enthalpy. And how, let me talk about that also. Suppose if we have an electron, I'll give an example in this case so as you could understand better. So therefore, suppose we have multiple shells and the outermost shell consists of one electron. And this is the most loosely bonded electron with that of the nucleus. And what we could say is that the inner electrons will contain multiple electrons. So I would consider that suppose the first shell contains two electrons, the overall second shell will contain an amount of 8 electrons. And the outer will be of one electron. So this is basically an example of sodium that I am talking about. So what in this case is actually, suppose we have to remove the outermost electron. So we could remove easily, but what happens if the shielding effect is less? So what will happen if the shielding effect is less? So shielding effect are shown by the inner electrons basically. So what do they do? So inner electrons, which are basically negative charge, and if they have more attraction towards the positively charged nucleus, as you could see. So what will happen if the number of electrons are more in the inner shell? So they will have more attraction towards the nucleus. So therefore, this will have more attraction towards the nucleus, which will result in the formation of a shield, a kind of screen. So as the nucleus will not attract the outermost electron, because most of the electrons are now being acquired or they are attracting towards the nucleus itself. So now this is the effect that is been shown in this case is known as the screening effect. So this will prevent the nucleus to attract the outermost electron, which will result in the overall resultant nuclear charge to get reduced. So therefore, the nuclear charge is now reduced because of the screening effect. But the screening effect also depends on the orbitals that it has. An atom has orbitals, right? Like s, p, d, f. So earlier also we have mentioned that the s has more screening effect than that of the p, than that of d, and that of f. So if inner orbitals consist of f orbital, if inner shell consists of f orbitals, then what will happen? The shielding effect will be very much less. So if the shielding effect is very much less in that case, so what will happen is the nucleus will have more attraction towards the outermost electron. And since the nuclear charge will be more, then it would be very much difficult for us to remove that electron. So now, since it is more difficult or more energy has been required to remove the outermost electron, so that means that the nuclear charge increases, then the ionization enthalpy also increases. But when we are talking about the shielding effect, so suppose if the shielding effect, like suppose if the inner orbitals consist of an inner shell consist of an s orbital, and as we know that s orbitals are known for their higher screening effect, so therefore this will lead to screen the nucleus so that it would have no effect of the nuclear charge will not have an effect on the outermost electron. Will have effect, but not that much as compared to the an ideal state. So in this case, what happens is the nuclear charge will get reduced, and because of which the energy that would be required to remove the outermost or the loosely bonded electrons will be less. So no more energy has been required to remove the outermost electron because it doesn't has an influence on the nuclear charge because of the screening effect. So that shows that when it comes to screening effect, so screening effect, I would represent it as SE. So screening effect is inversely proportional to basically ionization enthalpy. If screening effect is more, ionization enthalpy will require, it would be less. Or if the screening effect is less, then the ionization enthalpy, that is the energy required to remove that electron, will be more. So that is what the screening effect means. So these were the three factors that were affecting, and talking about the last one, that is the electronic configuration. Now we are going to look about the last effect or the last factor that would affect the ionization enthalpy, that is known as electronic configuration. So let me talk about electronic configuration. So how does the electronic configuration plays a very vital role in effector that would affect the ionization enthalpy. As you know that electronic configuration, some of the electronic configuration can acquire stability, means orbitals can acquire more stability when they are basically half filled or when they are completely filled. How? Let me talk about that. S orbitals are those which acquire maximum 2 electrons and can acquire half also. Can suppose if this is the orbital of S orbital, as you could see, so it could acquire, it is now empty, or it can be full by 2 electrons and can be half filled also. So now talking about the p orbitals, so p orbitals will have in this case basically 6 electrons will acquire this orbitals, that is for px, py and pz. So that means that all the orbitals can be completely filled. Or in this p subshell, basically I could write it as, now this are half filled, or this could be completely filled by filling all the electrons in this orbitals. So whenever might it be s, p, d or f, whenever an orbital or whenever a subshell is now half filled, we could say that it would have more stability. And because of this stability, what happens is to remove the electron from this orbitals will be very much difficult, and hence it would require more energy. So the electronic configuration also plays a very vital role. So whenever we will remove an electron, we should we observe that because of the number of electrons that are being filled in the orbitals, if they are half filled and half filled in the whole subshell, as we could see, or if they are completely filled, then for removing the electron when they are completely filled or when they are half filled, so as because they have acquired the stability, so because of they have acquired the stability, so to remove that electron it would be very much difficult. So that is what the electronic configuration is, the main factor that will depend on the ionization enthalpy. So unless suppose if we have a p or a p subshell which is not completely filled, but it will have suppose 1 electron or 2 electron as it has been shown here. So to remove this electron, it would be easy compared to that of the electrons which are half filled. So because of this, it is now basically extra stable. And because of this extra stability, the electron removing 1 electron among this, we can't remove 1 electron easily and we have to provide more energy. So therefore, this is the effect of it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood that how electronic configuration also takes place a very vital role in the electronic configuration for an ionization enthalpy. That is, ionization enthalpy will be more if the atom is acquiring stability in its orbitals. So, and also we have understood that what are the other factors that would affect the ionization enthalpy, that is the size of atom as well as the nuclear charge, the screening effect and the electronic configuration. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you will share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.